Hi. This is OD666666. Hi. Just looking. This is just my everyday. You know, I decided not to wear a mask today. You know. Ha ha ha. Okay, yeah. Let's bust on into it. They finally sent me chillers. If you remember from the last video, I was bitching about how my blood bank didn't get chillers with it. They were nice enough to send me individually another chillers. And that's if you guys haven't seen chillers, if you're into anthologies and shit, this is a really fun. I mean, it's low budget, but it's a very fun anthology, if I do say so myself. Yeah, got a few stories on there. Fun stuff. Shut up. Okay. This movie, like I was saying last time, I showed them the update I had, Blood on the Highway. This was a pretty fun movie. At first, you know, I was watching, I was like, oh, man. But you know what? It turned out to be a really fun movie. I ended up laughing. LOLing. I was LOLing. Because there was some funny shit in there, and I don't know. It's over the top, man. But you know what? It actually looked like a pretty decent budget movie. I mean, it wasn't like, you know what I'm saying. But the acting's not that bad. The effects are pretty good. I mean, yeah, there's a little bit of CGI thrown in here and there. That's kind of... But, I mean, it's not that bad. It's nothing that I really noticed and was, like, pissed off about. Oh, my goodness. The characters are likable. I'm getting all these pubes in my mouth from this little stupid thing. The characters were likable. And the shit was fun. I mean, you know, some of it. There's vampires in it. It's pretty much a vampire movie. It's funny stuff, man. If you're into that kind of thing, you gotta love that cover art. That is just awesome. I love it. But yeah, it was really fun, man. It's got music by Calabrese in it and shit like that. So I thought that was pretty cool. Then I got this. Severance. Kept hearing about this. Kept hearing it was a pretty decent movie. You know, I went to a Hollywood Video, of course, or a movie gallery, and got the closing out business sale. It was like 10 movies for $20. I mean, you can't go wrong with that. And then the guy screwed up, so I got them for $18. So that's awesome, 10 movies. But anyway, I just started picking stuff up that I thought might be pretty cool. This was pretty good, man. It was funny too. And I mean, it's hard. I have a certain dumbass sense of humor, but as you can probably tell. Yeah, this was a pretty fun movie. You know, if you read reviews, they're going to be like, man, it was so gory. Oh my god, it's had so much gore in it. I mean, it had some gore in it, and it was pretty cool, but it's not, you know. I mean, look, I mean, even on the back, it says hardcore gore. It's not hardcore. It's got some pretty cool gore in it, but it's not hardcore. But it is a fun movie. If you guys can get this cheap, you know, Hollywood Video Movie Gallery, I'd definitely pick it up. Why not? Now, the cream of the crematorium here. This movie... I've already talked to some people about it. I already told Mr. Parker how much I loved it in a message. And Andrew Gilliland, he's my buddy. But he loves this movie, too. This movie is awesome. It is so good, man. It's got the band, you know, the people in the front right there. That's Guitar Wolf. They're a Japanese punk rock garage band. They're really just loud, distorted, and awesome. I think they're really cool. But they're just really entertaining. I mean, even just the live show. I've seen the live show, which I haven't been to one. But I've seen them online, and I've seen, like, you know, DVDs of the live shows and shit like that. And they're a really fun band. I mean, they're just over the top, just fun. But this movie was so good. It has to be one of my favorites. It is probably... I can't tell yet because just, you know, I'm taking a while to seep it in. But it's one of my favorite zombie comedy, horror, weird Asian... It's awesome. I can't say more about it. I mean, it's a Synapse release here. The only thing that sucks about this release is it is full screen. It's not widescreen. But man, this movie is awesome. It's even got, you know, behind the scenes, you know, it's like little stuff. Behind the scenes music video and shit like that. But, oh man, definitely everybody needs to check out this movie. Jesus Christ. I think the same people every time. What's going on, Nate? You need to make a goddamn video, buddy. But, shit. you guys know who I'm talking about. You guys know the people that'd be interested in this. Check this shit out. I'm done talking about it, but seriously, this movie's so good. No lie, seriously. This movie, I did watch this finally. It's a fun movie. I did get the R-rated version. I heard there's an unrated version. I seem to think this is missing some gore. But this was a really fun movie. I was iffy about it at first, but Mr. Parker said it was pretty good. And, you know, you can usually believe his, you can believe his opinion. He's got good shit. But, this was fun. It was really fun. It's a serious movie. It's not corny. There's funny stuff. There's these security guards that beat the shit out of him in the prison and just annoy him. That's pretty funny. But it's good, definitely. If you like psychological, like serial killer shit, check that out, definitely. I got this Best Buy pickup. I haven't watched this yet. It's got Al Pacino and Harvey Keitel. It's like one of Martin Scorsese's first films about, you know, New York, Little Italy, you know, this little, you know, I don't know. I just read about it. I don't know much about it. But if you guys have seen this, let me know. That cover just looked awesome. I don't know. To me, it looks nice. It looks nice. But, yeah. Then I got this. I still haven't watched this yet. Psycho Kickboxer. It's just like, goofy as shit. And then I open it up. And, I mean, I just started laughing. I mean, look at that. You know? I mean, there's, like, some kind of, like, famous kickboxer that's in this movie playing the part of the main character, and he's goofy and obviously he can't act. I watched the trailer for this and it looked great. But if you guys have seen Psycho Kickboxer, let me know how that is. Then I picked this up, the Fanglies. I remember watching this years ago, and I picked it up because I got it cheap. It's really cheap. There's not a lot of blood and guts in it, but it's actually kind of a fun movie, but it's super, super low budget. That's all I can say about it. It's fun, though. It's about a witch and whatever. It's silly. Then I got this. Holy shit, if you guys have seen this movie, this is so goofy. I mean, it's a good movie. It's like, once I said, once again, it's really low budget. It's really silly acting and shit like that. It's got a lot of gore in it. The gore is not top-notch, but it's still fun. The title song for this movie, if you guys have seen this movie, you know what I'm talking about. It sticks in your head forever. Super fine. Yeah. I mean, that shit, you probably think I'm retarded for doing that if you haven't seen this, but if you have seen this, you know what I'm talking about. Then I got this. I don't know anything about it. Devil Girl just looked like a fun, I don't know, it could suck balls, I'm not sure. But if you guys have seen Devil Girl, let me know. Shit, I gotta hurry up. Then I got this. This is bullshit. This makes me mad. I haven't watched this yet because look at the shitty copy they gave me. They were advertising a Shriek Show edition of this, and they sent me this Classics. Man, I heard this thing was cut up and all that, so I emailed him bitching about it. But if you guys seen, 1990 Bronx Warriors, let me know how good that was. Then I got this. I haven't seen this yet. Eyes Front, Serial Killer, some kind of serial killer movie. It's got Michael Madsen in it. Looks, I don't know, it looks snug. It might be okay. I don't know, though. It might suck. Then I got this. The Legend Trip. I don't know. Another Hollywood Video pickup. I don't know. It just looked fun. It may suck. I'm not sure. If you guys have seen The Legend Trip, let me know if that's any good. Got Fly of the Living Dead. I have never seen this one. I was always like, I don't know about that shit. But I've heard it good things about it, so I don't know. I need to check it out soon. Zombies. So, I don't know. Fly of the Living Dead. Let me know what you think about that. Haven't seen it. Then I got The Mailman. Haven't seen this. This looks really low budget. Anchor Bay did release it, and they released some pretty good stuff. You know, so, you know, I figured maybe I can't go wrong with it. But maybe I did. So let me know if it's a piece of shit or not. I don't know. I got this. I haven't seen this yet either. Got Brutal. It's got, you know, Michael Berryman, Jeffrey Combs in it. That was a turn on for me. I was turned on by that. I was like, aww. But yeah, I don't know. It's got a chainsaw on the front of it, so I was like, hell yeah. Dead and Gone. I haven't seen this. It does say a bloody good time, so I said blood. All right. Hadn't seen that yet. Camp Slaughter. We watched a little bit of this. Looked okay. I've seen Nate talk about it. He said it was a pretty good movie, so I figured I'd give it a chance. Got it real cheap, so there we go. Got that. I haven't seen it yet. Oh my god, and I watched a little bit of this. This is terrible, man. Alright. If you guys have seen Rock and Roll Nightmare and you guys think that's a terrible movie, which it is, but it's fun as hell. It's got Thor in it. You know, the heavy metal Thor. Yeah, it's that movie's fun. But this movie, oh my god. Whoa. I just hit myself in the schnoz. But, Jesus Christ, this sequel, I had to get it because it's a sequel to Rock and Roll Nightmare, but it's like shot on video, they got some metal music playing, and you can't even hear the dialogue, they didn't mix the sound right, you can't even hear the dialogue over this metal music they're playing, I don't know, man. Wow. If you guys have seen Intercessor, another Rock and Roll Nightmare, let me know. I think Mr. Parker said he's seen it, and he said it was shit. But, yeah. Anyway, that's about it. I don't think I have anything else to talk about. I'm going to 10-minute mark. Hope you guys are doing all right. There's probably shit I'm forgetting about saying. I don't know. Oh, yeah. Me and Miss Odie 666, she wanted to watch some shit last night. I was like, what do you want to watch? She said, I want to watch some old school slashers, so, or some just good slashers. So we ended up watching Black Christmas, the original, had to show her that, and Intruder. And she dug them both. I was very proud of her. I was like, hell yeah. But anyway, yeah. So yeah, that's about it. That's about all for me. But you guys take it easy, and I'll catch you on the flip side. I'll catch you on the flip side. Bye!